Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 13 of Settlements and Survival. Today, we're going to go ahead and try and finish up in Diamond City so we can roam out elsewhere. Now, as we go down here at the beginning, I'm checking to see if the super mutants are there. They are not. They are dead. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give myself a marker. Now, you remember earlier on in one of the earlier episodes, there's a rad X in this little crate here, right? So what I do, what I like to do is I take the crate itself out of the van and I put it standing up in the street, right? So when I'm coming up from Hangman's Alley going to Diamond City, I'm usually just thinking about going to Diamond City. I'm not paying attention. But I look for that box in the street. So here's what I did between now and then. I did all this stuff and did all this maintenance and building and crap like that to get ready for Hardware Town. So anyway, I put the box in the street. So if the cell resets, if the super mutants come back, that box disappears. It goes back in the van. So now we're going to check for rights. We're going to see how Righteous Authority does on our way to Hardware Town to get Abbot's paint. And I'm going to test this thing out to make sure it's working good, to make sure I like it, to make sure whatever. And there's these dogs down here, right? So I zoom in, check it. Okay, good. One shot, one kill from stealth. Legendary, let's test it out. 1, 2, okay, 3, 4, 5, with a crit, and 6. 6 shots in the head to kill him. 4 shots to that guy. And I'm like, okay, this is not impressive. And of course, staggering pool cue. So this character's luck does not extend to legendaries, it only extends to antibiotics. She gets luck with antibiotics, but man, the legendary's just ass. So now we're gonna go around the side and I'm lost at this point. I don't know where I am. I'm like, wait, okay, the Vault 81's over there. Good, and I came from that direction, all right. Diner's over there with the super mutants. I saw the spikes. I'm like, okay, good. We'll skirt them and wait. Whoops, there's a guy right there. And a suicider. Fantastic. Time to go. So now we're going to hide over here, wait for them to go back to their, to reset, go across from right to left, and then snipe them. One nice thing I do like about this is the tiny little green dot of the sight. It makes it a lot easier to aim, you know. And it's cool. Look at that. They're on fire. That's cool as hell, right? Wow. Is he going to die? How many times did they shoot? They're like 20? 3, 4, 5. With a crit, and 6, and 7, and 8. Oh yeah, no, we gotta go. Hide behind the truck. And we're gonna triple up. We're gonna go, what I call triple up is basically Stimpak, water, and a full ration of food. So yeah, face me, you coward, as he runs away. Do you understand what cowardice means, Mr. Supermutant? Here's a hint. It doesn't involve running away. Okay, oh, well, I guess he's dead now. So clearly, the rifle works a little bit better. So here we go. Super Mutant from stealth, 1 and 2. 2 shots down and dead. So here's where I make a mistake. There was too many mutants running around, and I forgot who came from where. So I hear this Super Mutant right now, and I think he's inside the diner, because that's where he usually is. He doesn't usually come out of the diner. In this case, however, he did. And he's actually up on the roof, but I haven't figured it out yet. So I'm looking, right? I'm like, where is he at? And of course, I got Righteous Authority out again. I'm like, okay, maybe it was just a fluke. I know there's one super mutant left, me and him. I've got this energy gun. But let's light him up. 1, 2, 3 with a crit. And 4, and 5, and 6 with him on fire. Yeah, no, ballistic time. Sorry, Righteous Authority. We gave you a fair shake, dude, but that was incredibly poor. So we go around the block here, and I'm looking for a landmark. I'm like, where the hell am I? Ah, the pylon. Ben Street Sewer. So now I know Hardware Town's right over here by a Parkview Apartments, Fred Street, Diamond City again. And there it is. There's the front door. So now we're going to see the settler here. Oh, somebody help. They've kidnapped my friend. Okay. I'm going to get a little admission here. Even in my first playthrough, I straight up murdered her. And the reason for that is this. She's a block and a half from Diamond City. If her friend really got kidnapped, the guards are like 20 steps away. Just tell them and get some help, you know? But no, she's standing out there. I'm like, you're bait. I felt kind of bad, though, because I didn't know for sure. But when I went inside and heard him talking, I'm like, yeah, okay, ooh. So there's 2 more raiders back there. I don't go straight for them. Again, call back to the previous episode where you need some elevation. And there's this rock over here. Very, very nice rock. Hello, rock. I'm going to get up here, get some height, get some distance, and we're going to combine a couple of tactics that we've used previously. One is get up high, shoot down. 2, as soon as you shoot, move. Get behind so he can't see where I'm going. Scoot around the edge here. And then he's going to be looking up the hill, trying to figure out where I am. Right? Yep. sure as hell, he looked up the hill. It's like, now he knows where I'm at because I'm shooting him, but he didn't fare too well here. Now, of course, here I don't, for whatever reason, I don't pick up that left leg, but you know what? It's not the end of the world. It doesn't really matter. There's so much crap in this game. You can leave stuff behind for days. It just like, it never runs out, so why not? But here I'm going light because I know Hardware Town's got lots of stuff in it, and I'm not going in the loading dock, I'm not going in the back door, I'm not going in the front door. I'm going to the access hatch. I like the access hatch. Now I'm gonna be quiet here because I like this series.
What's taking so long? I know I just saw someone out there.
This one looked like a good mark, so just shut up and wait.
Maybe they went around back. Should we go check the loading dock?
Don't be stupid. We got two guys back there. I thought I told you to shut up.
But what if...
Hey! Told you to stop talking. Say another word, and I will make sure that you don't annoy me ever again.
Seriously, though, what if... Hey, what the hell?
What? I warned him. Now shut up and make sure you're ready.
I don't know if you've ever seen that, but that's one of my favorite exchanges in the game. That and the two guys over across from the library talking about the guy on the motorcycle, you know, making grenade noises with desk bands. Who has a desk band? I do, dude. Those things are awesome for upgrading weapons. They got gear, screws, and steel. So, another thing I'd like to do there is, of course, okay, so here's the entrance. Got an armor workbench and a weapons workbench. I like Hardware Town because of this. Because, you know, you can loot the hell out of it and scrap everything. So as I go through here and scrounge and look for things to get, I love those exchanges, though. You know, the like those two guys and like the guys, like I said, across from the library who talk about the guy with the desk band making grenade noises and the sandwich guys. The guys are arguing about a sandwich. I wish there were more of those little vignettes in the game. I really do. I mean, maybe there are and I'm just missing them. But I just, nice. Those things are so cool. I just eavesdrop on people. And they're so weird. So, of course, lock the door and go to the stuff. And see here, you can see the brackets on the hidden thing are flickering like crazy. So I know they're really close. And they're up probably over here to the right. Normally, I peek through the hole in the wall there. You can see them, but you can't shoot them. So we go in here, grab the picket fences, ignore the key. Of course, ignore the key because I've already opened the door, so I don't even need it. Grab the stuff in here and then double check to make sure it's not better than what I've got. I don't think it is because it's pocketed, but it's not shadowed. So shadowed is more important to me right now. So here's the peek around the corner trick. The gun drops and then you zoom in and you can peek around the corner. That's why I can shoot him like this and he doesn't move. He doesn't see me even though I'm obviously, you know, right there.
Oh, man,
so
back.
Since they're close, it takes them forever and a day to calm down. So I'm going to cut that part, skip ahead. Took about 30 seconds for him to shut up and sit down. And then I checked it down here, because sometimes they will path and come up that back stairway. Always check your six, right? Check your six, check your six. Now, the other half of the room, I didn't check it the first time through, so now I'm like, oh, I'll grab this stuff here. I never grabbed the snub-nosed pistol on the table there. It's a 44. And the reason I don't grab revolvers, because you can't really put suppressors on them. I mean, they're revolvers, you know. The sound they come out of the barrel that comes out of the chambers. So I leave the revolver, but if you want a big, heavy revolver, that's a really good one to get. Bye, demo.
No.
Now the Raider Scum's active. Raider Scum are tough. They're pretty up out there. So we're going to wait in the hallway for him, see if he comes around the corner. He does not. So I'm going to go out here and just wax him. Hey, dude. Oh, my God. Right there. So there you go. Now it's clear. And there's very few Raiders. There's like five or six Raiders in here. There's nobody in here, which is strange because you'd think in a place this big they'd have a lot of Raiders, especially as close to Diamond City as it is. But, of course, then again, maybe because they're close to Diamond City, they keep getting cleaned out. But on the other side of that coin, there was a named guy in here, so clearly he's been in here a while. So I don't know. Anyway, grab a little light stuff and take all that. And then normally when I go through here, I check every washer. I check every dryer. I check the refrigerators. I get the cap stashes. I climbed on the north wall to get that safe that's on the top shelf that I didn't know about till like 2 weeks ago. Apparently, I was talking to a friend of mine recently, and he's like, oh, yeah, don't you get the safe? I'm like, dude, I didn't even know about the safe till like 2 weeks ago. He's like, are you serious? I'm like, yeah, I never think to look up. So let's get the green paint. Apparently, I'm the only one playing Fallout that doesn't know about the safe in here. So I do now, though. So, hey, I get there eventually. So we get the paint. One nice thing about getting the paint is you don't have to pop out of stealth to use the machine. It's in like a terminal where you have to stand up. So that's kind of nice. So now we go get demo stuff and grab this guy's ammo. and we'll go over across the way. Yeah, but basically, if you jump across here or you jump off the fallen rack on the other side of the on the north side wall, you can get up there easy. Combat rifle, first one ever, level 14 combat rifle, not bad. And I grabbed the bolt action rifle, and right here I remember, oh yeah, there's workbenches. So let's go ahead and grab all their armor, all their weapons, everything they own, and we're just going to crush it. We're just going to destroy everything for the materials. Now, of course, I'm burdened here, but it doesn't matter because, you know, the thing's right here, you know, 10 steps away. And, of course, I got to stop right here and get the bones off the floor because, you know, and the desk bands. Yay, desk bands. So let's go ahead and work the workbenches, skip that whole part. I basically just smashed every weapon and piece of armor, which means more burden, more carrying capacity. So let's grab even more stuff. Because God knows we need more stuff. What else are we doing here? Checking the back, checking the bottom, check. You know one thing I never really understood about Hardware Town is how big the back room is and how small the showroom is. I mean, it's a big place. It's got lots of shelves. Sure, it's bigger than most of these stores around here. But I mean, if you look in the back after you look in the lobby here, right, because it's got, you know, some stuff here. It's not even as big as Watts, I don't think. Watts or what's the other one? Hesser's? Starts with an H. Anyway, here's the showroom, and then here's the warehouse. I mean, are they like a distribution center or something? I mean, do they have lots of like Hardware Town satellite stores? I've never seen another one, but who knows? They might be buried out there. So we're done. Yay. Hardware Town is complete. And we will go and we will discover Parkview. Now, the tip here this time is Parkview Apartments. You have to discover it from the back. There's only one little nugget place in the very, very back. By the driveway, carport, garage, right there. See that? The front door doesn't work. The side of it doesn't work. None of it works. So I just leveled up. We're going to buy a perk. Did you watch the last one? If you did, you know I'm going to buy. Gun nut. I checked Lone Wanderer. For some reason, I think Lone Wanderer is level 13, but it's not. It's 17. So we buy gun nut. Yay, gun nut 2. I can finally put a suppressor on that pistol. Yay, my life just got a lot better. Raiders active? Raiders where? Oh yeah, that's right, up on top of the Parkview building. There's three of them up there. And then there's that whole gang fighting the super mutants across the bridge at the very, very top. So, Penn Street Sewer, good. Now we go back to Diamond City and we'll talk to Mo. Let's grab some more stuff first though. We'll go ahead and talk to Abbot. Talk to Abbot, drop this off, and then we'll do some more maintenance. And this is about the end of this one, folks. Here's what we do this time around. Righteous Authority gets on display because I ain't using it. Upgrade the pistol and rifle. And I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching. I hope you enjoyed the show, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.